In this video, we are going to learn about the application of a named range, which we have seen in the last particular video. So over here, again the same data set we have taken. So you can try your hands on the same data set or a similar data set as a part of your exercise, so that the concept get ingrained in your day-to-day learning. So over here we have been asked four questions. First, we have to prepare script list. Second, we have to prepare companies list. Third, we have to prepare header list. And fourth, we have to make the drop down dynamic, as in list very dynamic. Okay, now there are two ways to prepare list. First way is to give a range directly. Second way is to give a named range. There is a difference, however. Named range is more dynamic in nature, as in more flexible in nature, instead of using the direct range as an input. So we will see how both the way works over here. So there is something called as data toolbar over here, and there is something called as data tools over here, and there is something called as data validation over here. Once you click a data validation, you have something called as data validation circle, invalid data, and clear validation circles. We will start with data validation. Once you click that, on the first tab, which is settings tab, there is something called as validation criteria, which allows you to choose what you want to do exactly with the list. So over here, we will create a list. We will choose list from the drop down. And then it will ask for a source. And what is the source from which you want to make a list? So now here we want to prepare a script list. So over here I will select all the script data over here, and then I will simply click OK. So as you can see over here, there is a drop down which has been created or which has been formed by the Excel. Once I click the drop down, you will see the all the input of the script list. So, and you can choose, pick and choose. And then depending upon this, you can do further functions. There is another way to do this. You define a name to this range, which is named range, which is security symbol. So let's give it name as security symbol. However, you can see that once you press enter, it says that you must enter a valid reference you want to go to, or type a valid name for the selection. You cannot give space over here, and hence the error. So I will just write security over here. Once I write security, so there is a named range which has been created in Excel, which is called a security. Now I will do the same function again. I will go to data tab, data validation, allow list. Instead of giving a range over here, I will directly give equal to script, and I will click OK. It says that named range you specified cannot be found, obviously because I have given a named range as security. So there is another learning you have to take. You have to be very precise with, because it's very case sensitive, you have to be very precise with what you are trying to give as an input over here. Once I write security and I click OK. So over here, you can see that the dropdown which has been created over here. And now the same input appears over here as well. So that's the benefit of named range, saying that if I want to change this range in future, I don't have to change the formula, neither I have to change the data validation. I have to just go to formulas, go to name manager, and I just have to change this security, which is something over here. I just have to change this reference, and all and the rest will be taken care of. So that's the advantage of named range. It provides so much of flexibility and so much of dynamism in the entire process. That's very helpful and very useful when you are creating a large Excel sheet which creates a dashboard, which contains a dashboard or any financial model. Similarly, we can prepare companies list over here also. So I will go by name range method. I will select the entire list of security, and I can write security underscore name, and I will click enter. And over here I will define it, data validation list equal to security underscore name. However, you have to note that when I am defining a named range, there should not be any space. Underscore and everything is allowed, but there should not be any space. So that's why with this name range, I have introduced underscore instead of a space, because we saw that once you try to enter space, it will give you an error message. So again, my dropdown has been created over here. Similarly, it says that prepare header list. So the table header list, it is asking me to prepare that, and I will create a name range over here. It says header, and in the dropdown, I will put this as a header equal to header, and it gives me output over here as well. So this is the use of named range. In the next video, we will see how the name ranged or how the list can be dynamic using offset. And in the subsequent videos, we will also see that how the name ranged using name range, how the list can be dynamic using index function. So that's pretty much about this video. Thank you.